and welcome to my YouTube channel Vocavita English. In today's video, we are going to learn how to write a letter in English. A letter can be written in a formal way or informal way. Formal letters are written to officials, to editors of newspapers, and to principals and people you don't know. Informal letters are written to friends, relatives, and people you know personally. Now, according to the latest CBSE format of letter, there are many misconceptions. In many other videos, you must have seen about 6 to 8 elements of letters. But let me tell you that there are total 10 elements of a letter format. Let's first discuss that. The format of a letter contains sender's address first, date, then salutation, then subject, then body of the letter, then thanking, subscription, that is closing subscription, sender's name, and ENCCCPP, that is the last element and that is always optional. As per the format, let's discuss each element in detail and the common mistakes we always make when we write these elements properly in a format in a letter. We are doing this letter according to the latest CBSE rules and norms. So whatever so far you have learned about the salutations and subscriptions, about punctuations and about the rules of writing a letter, you might feel something is different. So please listen carefully. Firstly, sender's address. Sender's address comes always on the left hand corner of the page. One common mistake that we always make with sender's address is we insert a punctuation. Like here, we have taken an example, 24, Bose Road. There will be no punctuation inserted in sender's address according to the rules of CBSE. Whether it's a sender's address or receiver's address, no punctuation should be marked anywhere. Coming next to day, you are going to always mark one line that I always tell my students that after every section, you have to leave one line. So this sign what you can see, that is for leaving a line that makes your letter look systematic and organized. After sender's address comes the date. The second element is date. The mistake that we make in writing a date in an English letter is the format of writing a date. We often write, suppose 20-5-20 or 20/5/20. Both the formats of writing a letter are only acceptable when you're filling a form. While you're writing an English letter, a formal letter writing, the only format that is acceptable is 20th May 20. Or it can be May 20th 2020. But dashes and slashes are not allowed when you're writing the date in an English letter. Coming next to the element of salutation. Salutation is how do you address? Who are you addressing? When you're writing a formal letter and you don't know to which department or to which person, male or female, your letter would be received, then it's always better that you write sir or madam. Sir or madam, anyone, or you can write slash both. Now the common mistake that we make here, that we write dear sir and dear madam, or respected sir and respected madam. So let me tell you that according to the latest rules of CBSE, the word dear and respected are not allowed in letters. You have to directly write sir or madam when you are writing about a letter. Informal salutation would be dear Rahul. That means it is your friend. So you can write dear Rahul, dear Priya. You can write that. But for formal letters, you have to be very careful and you have to write sir or madam only without preceding it with any kind of dear or respected. That is not allowed now. Coming next to the element of subject. Subject should be only confined to 6 to 8 words. Only 6 to 8 words. If you want to write a leave application, the subject would be only applying for leave, leave application, seeking for leave. If you are writing a complaint letter, then you have to write complaint against the loudspeakers or against a municipal department. It has to be very short. Your subject cannot extend to 2 to 3 lines. Remember that. Leaving one line after that comes
the main part of the content, that is body of the letter. Body of the letter is the area where your maximum marks are deducted if you are a student, and you make lot of mistake if you are anybody else. Body of the letter should always be divided into three parts or three paragraphs. It should be an introductory para, details para, and a conclusion para. Introductory para always starts with certain fixed phrases, and you should always remember these phrases if you want to really write a good piece of letter. So when you are writing a formal letter, you have to be very respectful, and you have to remember that you can start your formal letter with writing phrases like, with due respect, I would like to draw your attention, or with due respect, I would like to state that, or this is to inform you. In simple language, you can write that. If you are writing an informal letter, you don't have to be using such a formal language. So for informal letters, you can write the phrases as, I have not heard from you from a long time. I'm writing this letter in receipt of your letter. This is a response. I haven't heard from you from a long time. Hope this letter finds you in the pink of your health. Hope this letter finds you fit and healthy. Yes. So there are many ways, whether you're writing a formal letter or an informal letter, to start with your introductory para. The introductory para should be the beginning of your letter writing. That means it should state the reason why you're writing the letter. Second is the details para. Whether it's a complaint or it's a general informal letter, all the details shall be put in the second paragraph. So comparatively, the details para or the second para has to be the longest. Third is the conclusion para. In this para, we are writing about the actions that we are expecting if we are writing to the authorities or to the government, or we are writing about the conclusion or the summarization of the letter. How it has to be, what actions are you expecting, or what is the next outcome. If you are coming next week, you are informing I shall be coming next week. That should be your conclusion of the letter. Coming next to thanking you. Thanking you, a thanking line at the end should always be added. If you are writing for a formal letter and you are expecting an approval for your request, you can write thanking in anticipation. If you are writing an informal letter, for informal letter, you can write hope to see you soon. Give my love to the young ones. Yes? So any kind you can end a letter. Before the closing subscription, a thanking line always adds beauty to your formal letter or informal letter. Subscription here is the closing subscription, the closing part of the letter. When you close the letter, again there is a difference between closing a formal letter and closing informal letter. When you are closing a formal letter, your subscription would be yours truly, that is for the editors of newspaper. It will be yours sincerely or yours faithfully if you are writing to the officials. To the principal can be yours faithfully, your obediently, your sincerely. All these common subscriptions are only for formal letters. For informal letters that you are writing for your friends and relatives, your subscriptions will be yours affectionately, yours lovingly. Sometimes by mistake you use yours truly, and yours truly should never be used for informal letters. So remember that. Coming next to sender's name and sign. If you're writing a formal letter, you have to first sign, then put your name, and then put your designation, whatever you are, a cultural secretary or you are on any other position, that position you have to address in the brackets. Suppose it's an informal letter, then you only have to put a sign and write your name. Next is ENC, CC and PP. These terms not all the letters contain. It is optional, because only if you require these details to be given with your letter, to be attached to your letter, then only you can use these terms. ENC. ENC means enclosures. Suppose you are submitting your resume and you want the Xerox copy of your mark sheets to go with it, your experience certificate to go with it. If any other certificate, you have attended any workshop, you want that training workshop certificate also to be displayed, then that also you can attach, and that you can write in your enclosures as point 1 and point 2, what are enclosures at the end of the letter with the term ENC. Suppose you want the same letter to go to 3 more departments, then you're going to write CC, that means carbon copy. The same piece of letter is going to go to, you can write the name or the department to whomsoever it may concern. You can write both. In case you have enclosures and CC both in the same letter, then you have to first write enclosures, that means a short form for that, ENC, and then you have to write CC. What is the use of PP? PP, per procuration. That means that suppose the letter has to be forwarded, but the sender is not available. He is on leave, he is out of station, but the letter has to be signed and forwarded so that all work is going on, running smoothly. So for that, someone else, maybe a higher authority or maybe an equivalent authority, has to sign on behalf of them. In that case, the term PP is relevant. Suppose someone else is signing. Rahul Sharma, suppose, is the sender and is not available at that time. So his colleague is signing on his behalf. So if he is signing, then before the sign, he has to mention PP. That means that the signature is not mine. It's not of Rahul Sharma. It is of someone else. So that is the whole description of the letter. Now we are going to take one sample letter, because before the final submission of an English letter, you have to always check for 3 things. That is spellings, punctuation and grammar. If you are writing an English letter, your grammar has to be flawless. So let's go and see about a sample letter, how it's going to work with, and after final submission, how do we submit. So this is a sample letter. This letter I have written as an example, following all the format that just now we have learnt about the letter writing. So you can see at the left hand side of the page, we have written the sender's address, then we have left one line and we have written the date in the correct format. We have written the receiver's address. We have written the subject, that's leave application. We have written the salutation. And after leaving one line, we have started with our content. Introductory para. Let's read if we have made any mistake. 5 Park Street, Bhopal, 22nd May 20. The principal, Little Jewels, Bhopal. Subject, leave application. Dear sir, my daughter Tulika Sarkar is a student of class 2, section A of your school. On 20th May 20. She cannot attend school since she was ill. Therefore, I would request you to kindly grant her sick leave for that day. Yours sincerely, Vijit Sarkar. We have read the whole letter, how it is written. Now let's check if we have made any spelling mistake. Can you see any spelling mistake? First spelling mistake you can see here. This is a common mistake that is made. We often, by mistake, write P-L-E for principal, which is P-A-N. First spelling mistake. Any other spelling mistake can you see? Yes? Write down at the bottom. Yours sincerely. E is missing here. So we have got on to 2 spelling mistakes before the final submission. Let's check if we have made any grammatical error. 5 Park Street, Bhopal, 22nd May 20. Little Jewels, Bhopal, leave application. Dear sir, my daughter Tulika Sarkar is a student of class 2, section A of your school. Section A in your school. That is another grammatical error we have caught. On 20th May 20, she cannot attend school. Cannot. Another error, it should be could not, because we are writing the letter for something that has gone. We are writing for past tense. She was ill. So it will be could and not can. We have spotted two grammatical errors and two spelling mistakes. Now, before the final submission, let's check if we have made any mistake with the punctuations. Let's start again. 5 Park Street. Here you can see, and if you have heard properly in the beginning, no punctuation is marked in the sender's address anywhere or in the salutation anywhere. So this is punctuation error that we can see. Now the letter is all set and it is ready to submit. So this is how you have to first write down the letter, analyzing that you have included everything. One more thing to remember, that if you are writing ENC and CC, that would be coming right in the last. And if you are writing PP, that should be just before the signature. Before the signature, you will be writing PP. And 3 lines after the signature will be your 3 lines after the signature, you will be writing your ENC or CC. That is how you are going to end your letter and submit it finally.
So I hope you are benefited from my teaching and you'll remember the rules for writing English letters always. My next video will be on improving English speaking skills. If you like the video and you want me to bring more such videos, please like, share and subscribe my channel, and I'll meet you again every Wednesday and Saturday. Thank you for watching.